quite enjoy socialising with friends, watching sport. I'm quite into my journalism, and I also do a bit of radio presenting as well. The most important thing in my life is my brother. He's like a younger version of me. He's also a really great guy, and I think he'll go far in the future. My one and only pride and joy, well, it's got to be this mug. It's got my football team on it, and it's also got my name on it. What could be better? Live without, well, it's got to be, I'm partial to cake and chocolate, so it's got to be that. Oh yes, I like sweet things. I take quite a bit of pride in my appearance. I absolutely love my shirt collection. Here they are. One, two. My ideal date would be a nice meal, good company, good conversation. I'm quite a romantic, so I'd probably bring flowers, and it'd just be, I'd just like a really nice, relaxed occasion, really. It'd be a nice chance to get to talk to each other and get to know each other, so it'd just be something quite straightforward, but also quite nice at the same time. Another thing I like to do is stand-up comedy. I took it up a few months ago. A few friends said to me, "You're really funny, why don't you do stand-up?" So I signed up for it, gave it a go, and it's really taken off from there. I've done 2 gigs so far, and I'm really enjoying it. It's something that I really get a lot of fun out of. It's a real buzz, and the audience responds well to my joke, which is a really good thing.
4, 5, 6, 7... Eight. Oh, that's another one there. 9. 10.
Why are birds impartial? They just sit on the fence.
I'd say that Dan's dream date would be a kind of stereotypical one. I can imagine him in a restaurant, candlelit dinner, that sort of thing. He'd bring flowers, definitely. It'd make it really romantic. I think Dan would treat a lady really well. He's always quite a gentleman. If you need any help with anything as well, he's a good friend. I think it wouldn't just be a date, he'd be a friend as well, so he'd get on really well with the girl that he gets. Dan's very out there. If you take him to a club, he's the first one on the dance floor. Always the first one. If there's no one on the dance floor, Dan doesn't care, he'll take it over. He'll pull some of his special moves. And he's very courageous with that, really. I think it's quite brave. One of his favourite moves is the dying slug, which it's like kind of like the caterpillar, but it's a little bit different. It doesn't really move, it sort of sticks to the floor and goes like that a little bit. So don't pop, all the fun for Dan will stop.
Ladies, if you go on a date with me, you're going to really enjoy it, so please don't pop your balloons.